Hi, my name is Queen Abenacho, Miss Uganda 2018-2019.
I'm Bukenya Nasa, a model and also a teacher.
My name is Nakalema Mary. I'm a fashion designer.
What would I do if I caught my boyfriend cheating with another girl? Well, I'd wait for them to finish the business, then sit down with them and counsel them. Talk to them and find out why they would do such a thing to me. And if it doesn't work out well, life goes on.
I don't know. I kill them.
If I phone my brother in my house, banging my woman, damn. I actually don't know what I would do, because I think I'm a short-tempered person and I wouldn't say what I would do at the moment.
I invite you to join us at the beautiful Spectre Salon in Bugolobi for your nails, for your hair, for massage. There's a guy here, he can massage your hands. Yeah? And you go back home and you look at your husband like he's not there. Welcome to the show, it's Salon Talk. My name is Mary Luswata. Keep that feedback coming, especially on Twitter. Don't forget to use the hashtag Salon Talk on all our social media platforms. Share in the conversation. Let us know what you think. I'm about to introduce to you the ladies and the gentleman joining us on the show today. But before we go any further, have you heard of conversations? You know, when women get together to chat about relationships, money, men, that's where it ends. Sometimes children, yeah. But anyway, still family. So you'll hear women say things like, can you imagine this man, this son of God, he slept with a maid. He undressed my maid and he literally... the maid. Yeah, this show is for tonight. If your child is watching, I don't know why. Tell the babies to go to sleep, by the way. This is a PG-40. So he undressed the maid. Katobaya mutandikatia. Obaya mukonvincing atia. At least he would have slept with a woman who has like 2 degrees. Or someone who is taller than me. Or fatter. Or light skinned. But the maid, does it matter who your husband cheats with, or cheating is cheating? Get the conversation going. This one is going to be hot. Chiboko fire. Join the conversation. So anyway, now on to the introductions. There's a beautiful one on my right. She's very gorgeous. She makes me look like a man on this show. But anyway, what to do? Wama, what's your name?
Hi, my name is Queen Abenacho, Miss Uganda 2018-2019.
No wonder. And what's your name?
My name is Nakalema Mary. I'm a fashion designer. I'm also Miss Uganda's PA, personal assistant.
And you have a really nice voice.
Thank you so much.
And you're my namesake.
Really?
Do you love gossip the way I do?
I'm like you.
There's a man on the show today. Tugenda kunyiga. Literally.
Which is okay.
Yep. You want to be squeezed?
It's okay.
I'm yet to meet a man who doesn't want to be squeezed. Where I work, the guy say, Luswata, jangu wano nyigireko wano mukona. What is it with men? Wama, what's your name?
I'm Bukenya Nasa, aka mm-hmm. Super. Mm-hmm. I'm a model Super. And a teacher.
You a model? Let's just get straight into it. Let's not even waste time. Put it a ganjo cha. But, you know, Miss Uganda this year was really huge. We must commend the organizers. They put on such a wonderful show and Zari was there. I think Zari, in her head, she wants to be Miss Uganda. Or in her head, she's Miss... She wanted to be. She has always wanted to be. I think she would have crowned herself. She's like, Aliwa, you're musingo bulunji. Ladies and gentlemen, Zari Hussein, Miss Uganda. I always think she wants to be Miss Uganda. Somehow,
she is Miss
she
Uganda.
She is a queen.
She could have got everything.
I know.
What did you say? So her problem is age. Echumulime says that Miss Uganda age.
Don't stay on that point. Yeah.
No, nothing just goes by.
If it was age, Yandibada kolayo pageanti endala. Because Zari has got money.
Yeah, but we can't say me says because we all know Babyagana.
Yandibada kolayo Miss Mama. Never know.
Me, queen of mothers. Mama Uganda. Zari Ndozo, we are giving you ideas. And you said this show doesn't help you. We are giving you ideas, me, Mama Uganda. You would win that one. Don't even ask for people to compete. Just crown yourself. Miss Uganda this year, Was it the same gift? What do you guys get, Mpozi?
I got a car.
Mm-hmm.
A scholarship.
What kind of car?
Wish.
Hey, you upgraded to a Wish. Toyota Wish. Is it red?
No, it's silver.
I've not seen it on the road. Do you go anywhere?
I do.
How come I've not seen it? Where do you stay?
In Muyenga.
Because I work in Kansanga, but I have not seen the Miss Uganda. Is it branded?
Yes, it is.
Okay. So they used to tell us years back when Sylvia Wori used to manage Miss Uganda, but they prepare you for white men. Have you had one yet?
That's not true.
It's not true. Where are you there? Yeah. Huh? Were you there when Sylvia was running the pageant? Huh? You were not there.
Mm-hmm.
So Brenda does not prepare you guys for white men.
No.
Ah. Mm-mm. You see, Brenda is managing this thing much better.
Perhaps new management, new activities.
New activities. Yeah. So now it's not white men, it's Nigerians.
Not Nigerians. Because the thing is, in Miss Uganda, because I was among the top 10 girls, mm-hmm. I was also in Miss
Uganda. You're so beautiful. I love your color complexion.
Thank you so much. Uh-huh. Like, Bagamba, Bakwa, Bulichin, they give you everything in Miss Uganda bootcamp. Mm-hmm. Chiri Jolly, you use it or you leave it.
Mm. Yeah. What do you mean give you everything?
They give you equipment, they give you skills, they teach you everything. They taught us everything. Mm. Yeah, Katri, Chiri Jolly.
What did you learn most? What did you take from that boot camp?
I went to boot camp. I was a tombi. Mm-hmm. Now I'm a girl. You can also.
Miss Uganda, I'm always fascinated, especially this year. It was such a grand event, and I will say thank you to Brenda Nanyonjo and the entire team. From Bizu, the other thing is, Bizu, why does Bizu in her head, she's also still Miss Uganda?
Yeah, she is.
No, once she's not.
Queen, you're always a queen.
No, Bizu, yes. Bizu tava kumikolo aringa soda. And every time she's there, she's wearing that crown.
You use your crown until the end, until you die.
You used your crown until you die.
Yes.
Speaking of crowns, have you guys heard that Mbonye bought one of your people's a car?
It's been all over the news.
It's been all over the news. Are you Ella's friend?
Yes, I am.
As in friend, mm-hmm. or just friend because you guys are both Miss Uganda?
We are friends.
Friends?
Yes.
As in if she, would you know who bought that car? Are you that close?
Yes, we are.
So who bought that car?
That is a secret I'll keep.
Is it Mbonye? Is it some Nigerian boy?
No.
Who bought Ella's car? Because I can guarantee you it was not Mbonye. Get it from me. Forget what you've heard. The good prophet did not buy Ella. I know Ella is always there. Hmm? Maybe you should go there as well. Ella went there and found a blessing, a Lexus, and a big, big... Do you think Ella has money to buy fuel? You're her friend.
She does.
An actress? When was the last time she acted?
She's now acting in Nigerian movies.
Really?
Yes. How are we doing exactly? Ngate tubiraba ku TV.
I'm going to bring you one.
It's like also Fabiola has been filming something in Nigeria for donkeys. Until she came back here and just realized Omanyi kanzire ku TV za Uganda. I mean, I be Nigeria. I be like, I cannot. Ella is doing Nigerian movies.
Yes.
Give us one title.
I'm going to say, I'm going to tell you a movie like at the end of the show. One movie she is.
So after they poured the content, she watched it with her family. By the way, don't worry. When I just started doing radio, only my mom used to listen to me. I can guarantee you, only my mother. So if Ella's family is the only one watching her movies, it's okay. It's a start.
Yeah.
Give me the title.
I'm going to give you the title, First Wait.
Is it on YouTube? No! Ella's movie is not on YouTube. It's not!
The title.
Give me the title.
I'm going to give you the title at the end of the show.
You guys. Meanwhile, Ella, if there is a title, because people here don't remember. Your friend does not remember your movie title. I say if your friends do not know even one title of a movie you've acted, this career needs rebooting. It needs Jesus. In fact, the next time you go to Mbonye, please, maybe he should pray for that. Actress? But anyway, before we even go any further, what does a Miss Uganda PA do?
Like, I arrange for her what to put on.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you go into her closet?
Yes.
And you organize her outfits?
Yes.
Money,
she has money.
She has money. You have money?
Yes.
Do you have a boyfriend with money?
No, I have money.
I know
money
you didn't
personally.
Expect that. You didn't see that coming. You have your own money. Mm-hmm. Besides Miss Uganda, what do you do?
I used to do ushering and then plus different projects back home.
Different projects?
Yes.
Back home. Where?
Home in Mayuge.
Hey, back home in Mayuge. There's a very good friend of mine who came from Mayuge, but he passed on. You remember, do you know a gospel musician called Mark Elvis?
Mark Elvis. I think I've heard of the name, but...
Yeah, he passed on. Anyway, that's the time I went to Mayuge. So, you say you have projects. What kind of projects do you
have? Farming. Sugarcane growing.
Hey, you grow sugarcane. Ah! So, what do you do besides being Miss Uganda's PA?
I'm a fashion designer. Mm-hmm.
You work with your dad? You get down and you make outfits?
Yes, mostly we make uniforms for Kololo, Divine, Nadia.
By the way, the reason I'm asking these questions, because you say these are two beautiful ladies on the show with their nails very well done. You would never imagine they get dirty. But if you are one of the girls who go to lounge and you think you're going to just cross your legs like this, have your nails done, because that's the trend these days. We're waiting for men to give us their money. You know what, when he's buying your panties, because that's if you're not working, that's what he's going to do. He's going to be buying your underwear. You will be exactly, if I did not give you money, where would you have got your panties from? And then you, because he's the one buying them, you can't take them off for anybody else, because the day you do, he will shoot you dead. Let's get into our topic of the day. We're going to talk about women and you thinking that because he slept with your sister or he slept with a woman who is taller than you or more beautiful than you or who has got more money than you or got more class, it's much, much better than him sleeping with a maid. Does it even matter? He cheated. That's it. He cheated. Let's come back.